Dear learners, welcome to this session. In this session, we will discuss the descriptive assessment, that is assignment, how we can create an assignment for our own MOOC courses. So this is one of the component for internal assessment. Student can answer to the questions for the assignment. So teacher can have an option to keep the assignment as an internal assessment or self-test for the student to understand the subject very much. So we will discuss what are the requirements for designing the assignments. So first of all, selecting the appropriate assignment, which is very important here. Before getting into the descriptive type, we will discuss what is the difference between objective type of assessment and the descriptive type of assessment. The main focus of the assessment is to measure the learning outcome. That is, we have to keep in mind that we are going to test the student to measure the learning outcome. So learning outcomes are in the course. So to test the learning outcome, we can design the objective type assessment or otherwise descriptive type of assessment. Objective type assessment is highly structured and require the learner to supply a word or two or to select correct answer from the limited number of alternatives. So we have discussed earlier also about the objective type assessment. There are many objective type assessments are there. So the appropriate test can be placed to test the learning outcome by using the objective type assessment. The descriptive type assessment is like a writing on essay type or short answer type, permit the learners to select, organize and present the answer in essay or short form. That is the thing. Here the student have a more skill to select the content and organize the content and present the answer in an appropriate format. And there is a comparison between the objective and descriptive type of assessment. One is learning outcome measured. That is the main focus of the assessment. How to measure the learning outcome? So objective type helps to measure the learning outcome efficient for measuring the knowledge fact. So whether they have reached, they gain the knowledge by reading the subject. Measuring the understanding, thinking, skill and other complex outcome. If you want to measure it, then you can go for the objective type of assessment. So disadvantages, it is insufficient or inappropriate for measuring the ability to select and organize idea, writing ability and some type of problem solving. So suppose if you want to test the writing ability, then objective type of assessment may not help you to test the writing ability. Similarly, problem solving skill. For that, you have to go into the essay type of question. So for essay type of question, it is like you can measure the understanding skill and also the complex learning outcome, but appreciate for measuring the ability to select, organizing ideas, writing ability and problem solving skill required for the particular subject. So if you want to test the problem solving skill, then you can go for the essay type or short type of question. If you want to test the understanding and knowledge fact and all, then you can go for the objective type of questions. And preparation of the questions. Oh, this is for our own. If you are going to prepare the question, it is a relatively large number of questions are needed for testing, because multiple choice you have to give minimum 5 or 10 like that, so that the student can able to test themselves or to justify the measuring the learning outcome. So preparation is very difficult and time consuming, because for each question you have to prepare 4 alternative options and correct answer appropriately, which should be matching with more or less similar, so that the student can get the difficulty level will be there to choose correct or appropriate answer. For essay type, it is very easy to prepare and need very less time to prepare the essay type questions. And similarly, if you are going for the sampling of the course content. If you want that course content, it provides a extensive sampling of course content because of large number of questions that can be included in the test. So sampling may be more for objective type questions, but sampling of course content is usually limited because of smaller number of questions that can be included in the test. For example, if you are giving for the 10 mark question, the objective type you can frame 10 question, 1 mark each. Here you can go for the 2 mark question for 5 questions or 3 mark question for 3 or otherwise 2 5 mark questions, so that student can able to write and organize and present very well with the essay type of questions. And control of learner's response. In the objective type, it is completely structuring of the task, limits the learners to type response called off, prevents the buffling or avoid the influence of writing skill. However, selection type items are subject to the guessing. So these are the about the objective types. And essay type, this is a freedom in own words, enabling the buffling and writing skill to influence the score. However, guessing is minimized because here you cannot guess the answer, but if you are not able to provide correct answer in objective type of questions, the guessing can be possible. The student can guess the answer and then they can click on the multiple choice and to get the mark. But in the essay type question, they have to write the answer properly and present it properly, then only the response can be able to correct appropriately. And scoring, for objective scoring is quickly and easily. If you are going for a computer based objective test, that student immediately after submitting the test, they will immediately get the mark because this computer based give the spontaneous result for the objective type of questions. But subjective type questions, that is very slow, that the teacher has to go through the thing and then they have to give the mark and they have to justify why they are giving that mark. That is very important. And influence on learning usually encourage the learner to develop a comprehensive knowledge to specific facts and the ability to make fine discrimination among them. And it encourages the development of understanding skill and the complex outcome if properly construct the objective type questions. But in essay type questions, encourage the learner to concentrate on large unit of subject matter with a special emphasis on ability to organize, integrate and express the idea effectively. It also encourages the poor writing habit if the time pressure is a factor. So almost always in the student used to say that time is not enough. But even though if you are there poor writing or poor handwriting, then teacher can manage with that and then try to give the marks to that particular type of assignments too. That means essay type questions also. Reliability, this is the objective types are highly reliable in is possible and is typically obtained with a well structured test because you have to give the properly structured questions for the objective type of testing. Here reliability is low because of the inconsistent scoring. An essay type question, the learning outcome concerned with the ability to select, organize, relate and evaluate idea required for freedom of response and the originality provided for by the essay questions. So student can able to select and organize and relate and evaluate the ideas. And there is a freedom to write and then you can say that there is a originality will be there because there is if they are writing their own, there is not a copyright issue or there not be a plagiarism issues are there when they are writing the essay type of questions. Yeah, if it is possible for the plagiarism if they are giving the computer based and all, but that can be taken care by the software too. What type of essay or short type of questions are available. There is a restricted response questions and extended response questions. Restricted response questions tend to limit both content and the form of learner's response. For example, indicate whether you are agree or disagree with. These are the restricted type of, because you are confined with whether you are agreeing to that particular topic or disagreeing to the particular topic, why. And list the reason with the support. If you are giving the restricted response, then you are limiting the response, saying that list the reason why you are supporting to that particular component. Like that you can restrict the questions for the responses. Extended response is provide a wider range of latitude. The learner is free to select any factual or information that he or she think appropriately. For example, compare and contrast, critically evaluate the significance of some component, or describe the influences, like that. So you are providing the wider range where the student can think and critically evaluate and present the answer properly. So what example for the measure the learning outcome by restricted response questions or extended response questions. For a restricted response, you can ask, explain the cost and effect of relationship, describe, present and relevant argument, formulate hypothesis, formulate valid conclusion, state whether it is necessary assumption and all, and describe the limitation of data and explain the method and procedure. These are the way of formulating the restricted response questions. An extended response question can be formulated by produce, organize or express ideas, integrate the learning in different areas, create original forms and evaluate the worth of ideas. These are the some of the way you can formulate the extended response questions. So some suggestion for constructing the essay or short questions. Restrict the use of essay question to choose learning outcome which cannot be satisfactorily measured by the objective type items, and formulate the question that will call the behavior specifies in the learning outcome. Formulate the question that will be measure the behavior specifies in the learning outcome. Phrase the each question so that learner task is clearly indicated, and indicate an appropriate time and for each questions. For example, this is very important, that is, indicate the approximate time limit for each questions. So appropriate time limit, for mostly we used to tell that write and explain the concept with the word limit of 200 or 500, like that. The student can have that, they have to limit the answer with the 500 words, like that. So that will be time limit you are giving to the student. And avoid the use of optional questions. If you want to construct measure the concrete outcome, learning outcome, then you can avoid the options also. So if you are giving the options, then student can easily skip some of the concept and they will focus on only one concept to gain the more mark in that particular subject. And a suggestion for scoring the essay or short questions. So prepare an outline for expected answer in advance, so that what are the main points the student has to cover it in this particular question. Use the scoring method which is most appropriate. You can, scoring method can be created before evaluating the assignments or essay type questions. Decide on prevention for handling the factors which are irrelevant to the learning outcome being measured. Evaluate all answers to one question before going to the next question, and give the mark for that particular question, so that you can going to the next question, you can go for the next by giving the scoring to the next question. Evaluate the answer without looking at the learner's name. So that is important, because if you are seeing the learner's name, you may have a bias for with the giving the mark to the student. Especially important, a decision ought to be based on the result obtained two or more independent ranking. That is also very important, because if you can take the decision and you can give the result before seeing the ratings or before giving the mark, based on the response given by the learners. If you are seeing to this one, you can use the restricted type of assessment and also extended type of assessment for both pen and paper as well as the online assessment. Online assessment, apart from the essay type, short answer or objective type of question, you can move further for easily get the feedback from the student so that quick action can be taken. So online assessment, or so that the student can get the feedback and for their own learning. So online assessment can be self-assessment, can be peer assessment and concept mapping. So you can ask the student to create a concept map for particular subject. An online class assessment technique also possible, and discussion forum is coming up with the online thing, where you can raise the, as a teacher you can raise the issue, the student and peer group can contribute and then they can discuss among themselves, and also you can form a group to discuss, that particular group will discuss the concept and come with the presentation or come with the documentation. And you can use a blogging, which is a web 2.0, that can be also used as a learning journal. Student can record their learning journal in the blogs, which can be evaluated later. And also wikis, where student can contribute, collaboratively develop a content that may be evaluated by the teacher. And portfolio is coming up with this e-portfolio and portfolio, where the output of the student, that student response, can be stored in that particular portfolio, which can be carried further for their own career opportunity or that final examination also. Survey is also possible to test the student ability or learning outcome. And with this, we have discussed the how to create the descriptive type of assessment in the online course or in the MOOC courses. Thank you.